Hey, welcome back to my new video. This is Easy Tutorials, and for those of you who are the first time in this channel, please consider subscribing. Today we'll be creating this. Before we start, I'd like to invite you to support me on Patreon. This way you will get access to all my premium content, including a lot of logo reveals and slideshow templates. In this tutorial, we'll be using the Easy Tool script, which is free to download. You can get it by clicking the link from the upper right corner of this screen. You can also download the project files and the template separately. This way you will be able to create this wonderful logo reveal. Even if you don't want to download my template, you can find the download link in the description. So let's start. Import the files you need into After Effects. Let's create a new composition and name it, Logo Animation. I'm using a full HD 1080 pixels preset, with 30 frames per second, and 5 seconds long. Create a second composition and name it, Logo Placeholder. Let's make it 400 by 400 pixels, with the same duration as the first one. Grab your logo and drag it inside the placeholder composition. As you can see, my logo fits the composition size. If yours doesn't, just resize it to make it fit this composition size. Close this composition, grab the logo placeholder comp, and drag it inside the logo animation composition. Open its position options by clicking Ctrl+P on your keyboard and change the Y value to 440. Now, we'll have to slice the logo comp in equal parts. Click here and activate the grid and take a closer look. This size fits exactly for 5 equal slides, but you can create as many as you want. The process is the same. So, let's create 4 more copies of this layer. Select the top layer, grab the rectangle shape tool from here, and draw a mask like this. With the mask selected, switch to the selection tool, and double-click on your mask. Now, you will be able to edit it. Zoom in as much as you need to see better the lines, and try to align the top line as good as you can. Do the same with the bottom line, but leave 1 or 2 pixels more. This way you will avoid having gaps between your masks. Select your mask from here, copy it, paste it to the second layer, then, click M on your keyboard to open its options. Let's change its color to something different to make it more visible. Now, grab the mask like this, and try to fit the upper line as perfect as you can. Copy the mask and paste it to the next layer, and repeat the process. Do this with all the copies of the logo placeholder composition. When you will paste the mask to the last layer, this one will disappear. Don't worry, we'll fix this just by dragging the mask in its final position. Now, you can switch off the grid and adjust the position of your masks if you can see any gaps. Great. Make all your layers 3D, then, select the top layer and open its rotation settings by clicking R on your keyboard. Move to 15 frames, create a keyframe on the Y rotation, and change its value to minus 270 degrees. Go 1 second and 5 frames forward, and change its value back to 0 degrees. Select these keyframes and easy ease them. Then, open the graph editor, select this keyframe and drag its handle slightly to the left. Select the keyframes again and copy them. Move to 15 frames, then, select all the other layers and paste the rotation keyframes on them. Now, we'll have to stagger the layers, so, first, move to the beginning of the timeline, then, move 3 frames forward and change these layers' start point. Move 3 more frames, unselect the top layer and change the other's layer's start point. Repeat these actions with all your layers. This is how our sliced logo reveal looks until now. Create a new black solid and name it background. Apply the ramp effect to it, then change its settings like this. Change this value to 1080. This one to 5000. Change the ramp shape to radial ramp, click the swap colors button, then, change the ramp scatter to 100. Move the background layer to the bottom of your composition, and see how it looks now. To give it a more realistic look, create a new spotlight with these settings. Color white. Intensity 100%. Con angle 180 degrees, and cone feather 71%. If you preview the sliced logo reveal again, you will see that looks different now with the shadows that the spotlight casts on it. Select these boxes on all the logo layers, then, activate the motion blur from here. Great, now let's add the tagline. Grab the text tool and type your desired text. I will use the Gotham font with a dark gray color, but you can use any font you want, just don't make the text wider than the logo. Center the text's layer anchor point, open its position options, and change the values to 960. And 720. Create a new shape layer and rename it, Matte. Add a rectangle and a fill to it. Then, open the rectangle path 1. Unlink its size values, and change the X value to 400. Move the anchor point of this layer to middle right, open its position options. Change its X value to 760. Move to 1 second and 15 frames, and change the Y value to 720. Then, create a keyframe. Move 1 second forward, and change the X value to 1160. Select both keyframes and easy ease them. To make the text reveal, change the text layer track matte to alpha matte. Create a new black solid, and name it flare. Search for the lens flare effect, and apply it to your solid. change the lens type to 105 mm prime, then alt-click the flare center stopwatch. Let's make a little more space here, then, grab this pick whip, and parent it to the mat layer's position. This way, the flare will move together with the mat, without the need to add new keyframes. To make our sliced logo reveal visibly again, change the flare blending mode to add. As you can see, the flare is too bright, so, move to 1 second and 15 frames, create a keyframe on flare brightness and change its value to 0%. Move 15 frames forward, and change its value to 60%, then, move another 15 frames, and change the value back to 0%. Activate the flare layer and reveal its keyframes. Select all of them and easy ease them. Let's make another quick preview of our slices logo reveal. Looks great. Create an adjustment layer, and name it CC, from color correction. Apply the curves effect to it, then create a simple S shape on the RGB line to give it a little more contrast. Create a new black solid, and name it Fader. Go to the first frame, open its opacity option by clicking T on your keyboard, and create a keyframe. Move 15 frames forward, and change its value to 0%. Go to 4 seconds and 15 frames, and create a hold keyframe, then, move to the last frame, and change the value back to 100%. Bring the sound effects file into your composition, and you are done. Let's check the final result. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial on how to create a sliced logo reveal animation in After Effects. Don't forget to subscribe, hit the like button and comment. It would be great to know your opinions on my tutorials. Also, you can make requests for new tutorials on interesting effects or animations that you would like to learn. See you soon.